How many of you believe in the power of prayer? Can I hear an amen? Parang di ako kumbinsido. How many of you believe in the power of prayer?
Amen.
This month of May, I believe that God is waking us up as a church. There is a great awakening in our church to get back on our knees once again and develop the habit of prayer. In line with the mentoring and training of our church, last month on April 28, the primary disciples have undergone mentoring and training. And the topic was daily devotion and prayer. You see, God has given us a command in Joshua 1 verse 8. And it says there, "This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do according to what is written, for then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success." Take a look at the verse. In this text, we have been commanded by God to take the book of the law, which is the Bible. Everybody say Bible. Take the Bible. And the words from this book, it says there, must not, shall not depart from your mouth. But instead, we must meditate on it when? Day and night. Come on, say it. Day and night. So we must not do this just once a week on Sundays when we are in church. But there must be a daily habit of Bible reading and prayer. And so as we read the Bible every day, of course, we learn from it. We respond by applying what we have heard. And then we pray based on the revelation that we receive from the Word. Now, the end result, what is the end result? You see, this is a command with a promise. What is the end result? What is the promise? The end result is that your way will be prosperous and we shall have good success. Church, this is a very basic teaching in the Bible. However, honestly, not all of us abide by it. Many do it, but not regularly. Only when it is convenient. But you see, this is a clear reason why our ways are not prosperous. And the reason why we are not attaining good success, kaya wag ka nang magtaka kung bakit palpak ang buhay. Kasi may command with a promise na hindi natin sinusunod. But who among us wants to be prosperous? Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Who among us wants to attain good success? The key is to read your Bible and pray every day. Amen. Hallelujah. Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon. And so for the past 2 weeks, the primary disciple makers of our church that are being trained have started doing daily devotions. Every day we read one chapter in the Bible, one chapter lang. Okay? And we have started in the book of John. So everybody reads that one chapter, particular chapter, and out of that one chapter, each one chooses one or two verses. And then each one meditates on it. We write our insight or reflection. And then we write a short prayer based on that verse. And then what we do is we post our daily devotion on a private Facebook page that is only intended for this. And then everyone gets an opportunity to read and comment on each other's entry. Okay, so ang ginagawa namin, okay, listen, because we're all gonna do this, okay? I'm giving you the example and the template. So this is what we do, the primary disciples. Every day, I post this daily devotion. This was yesterday, Saturday, May 11. Everybody puts their daily devotion on the comment section. Just like that. Okay? Every day. And I check it. And everybody reads one another's devotions. And we all learn from each other. Today is the 15th day. And we have already been doing this for almost half a month now. Praise the Lord. Today we are reading and reflecting. So kung kahapon ay John 14, today is John 15 na. Now, why am I telling this to you? To all of you, church, if you desire to apply Joshua 1:8 to your lives, if you want to be prosperous, and if you want to attain good success, alam na ninyo yung susi, based on Joshua 1:8, I encourage you to do the same. Read your Bible and pray every day. Start the habit of daily Bible reading and prayer. So primary disciple makers, I think it's time for us to teach and facilitate and do the same template to our disciples. And for sure, if we will keep this commandment from the Lord, pagpapalain tayo ng Panginoon. How many of you believe in that, church? Amen. Palakpakan natin ng Diyos. Hallelujah! So thank God that He is organizing our corporate daily devotion. I know that a lot of you, if you have been a Christian for a long time, you are doing your daily devotions already. Pero iba pa rin, it's still different when you are together, you doing it together as a family. Amen? So this is something new, but we are getting there. Amen? They said that it takes 21 days for a thing to be a habit. Okay, if you do it consistently for 21 days, according to survey, it's going to be a habit. And now we are on the day 15th. And for you who are being discipled, if you have a disciple, discipler, disciple maker, then we are going to teach you and impart you to you the knowledge on how to do this. Amen. Now, on Friday night, hallelujah, we conducted a night of fire. Praise the Lord. So if you would count how many people came, there's 30, I think, in the picture. Amen. So 30 people came for an evening of soaking in prayer and worship. It was indeed an extraordinary night. Praise the Lord. I have felt the moving of the Holy Spirit hovering in the sanctuary of the Lord. We prayed and we consecrated ourselves individually. We took time to pray for one another. We surrendered to God our requests, our supplications, intercessory prayers as a whole group, and then there were assigned prayer leaders. If you want to see what happened last Friday, it's recorded in our Facebook page. But what I am praying and what I am hoping for is that the next time we have a night of fire, you will not miss it. And you will be able to attend and experience the moving of the Holy Spirit and fire just as well. Amen? Sa inyong mga hindi pa nakapag-experience ng ganito, don't miss it. There's a different power that you will attain from this. Glory to God. Hallelujah! Now, I am not preaching yet. That is just my introduction and announcement. But now, we are proceeding to the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. Can I have a tissue box, please? Our theme for today is the power of a mother's prayer. Thank you. Can we all read our theme? Okay, hallelujah. Thank you, Sister Rosel, for that video banner, and thank you for playing that, Brother Mark. How many of you watch the video banners of what the message will be on Sunday? Nakikita nyo ba? Ba't parang walang nagla-like? I-appreciate nyo naman. Ayan. Hallelujah. But thank you, mga kapatid, our graphic team and media team for always, consistently doing your best for the Lord. Amen. The power of a mother's prayer. Our text is based on 1 Samuel chapter 1, verses 1 to 16. We will read a portion of the story first and then iisa-isahin natin. There was a man named Elkanah who lived in Ramah in the region of Zuph in the hill country of Ephraim. He was the son of Jeroham, son of Elihu, son of Tohu, son of Zuph of Ephraim. So who is the man? Hello, who's the man? Elkanah. Verse 2. Elkanah had two wives. How many wives? Mga lalaki, sana all? In the Old Testament, during that time, they were allowed to have more than one wife. But now things have changed. Anyway, don't judge this. It is God ordained. So be it. But at that time, Elkanah had two wives. And the names of the wives are who? Hannah and Penina. Penina na lang. Some say Penina, pero Penina. Penina had children, but Hannah did not. Can you picture the story? Let's move on. Every year, Elkanah would travel to Shiloh. Shiloh is a faraway place, but there's a temple in Shiloh. Nandoon yung temple. And they would travel to Shiloh, Elkanah, to worship and sacrifice to the Lord of Heaven's armies at the tabernacle. You see, in the Old Testament, the people are mandated to at least ha minimum, go to the temple to sacrifice, lay an offering on the altar so that your sins for the whole year will be covered. Alam niyo yung doktrinang yon sa Old Testament, right? Okay, so Elkanah would do this every year. Now, the priests of the Lord at that time were the two sons of Eli. Eli was the high priest, and the two sons were Hophni and Phinehas. On the days Elkanah presented his sacrifice, so days, it's not just one day. Bumiyahin na rin lang naman siya doon, nagtagal siya. It's a day, days, a number of days of offering. So on the days that Elkanah presented his sacrifice, this is what he would do. He would give portions of the meat to Penina and each of her children. And although he loved Hannah, he would only give her one choice portion because the Lord had given her no children. Kids teachers, please. Thank you. Kalma. Did you get it, guys? So Elkanah would offer the meat and the blood of the meat. And out of meat, siguro magkakatay ng baka, let's just say, bull. Out of that cow or out of that calf or out of that bull, he would give portions of the meat to both of his wives and his children. So automatically, Elkanah and the children would have bigger portions kasi may mga anak. But Penina, the other wife and the children would have more portions, but only smaller portion for Hannah because she had no children. You get the picture? Let's move on. So Penina, yung karibal na may anak, Penina would taunt Hannah and make fun of her. Why? Because the Lord had kept her from having children. Year after year, it was the same. Peninnah would taunt Hannah as they went to the tabernacle. Each time, Hannah would be reduced to tears and would not even eat. "Why are you crying, Hannah?" Elkanah would ask. "Why aren't you eating? Why be downhearted just because you have no children? You have me. Isn't that better than having 10 sons?" Once after a sacrificial meal at Shiloh, Hannah got up and went to pray. Eli the priest was sitting at his customary place beside the entrance of the tabernacle. Hannah was in deep anguish, crying bitterly as she prayed to the Lord. And she made this vow, "O Lord of heaven's armies, if you will look upon my sorrow and answer my prayer and give me a son, then I will give him back to you. He will be yours for his entire lifetime. And as a sign that he has been dedicated to the Lord, his hair will never be cut." As she was praying to the Lord, Eli watched her. Seeing her lips moving, but hearing no sound, he thought she had been drinking. "Must you come here drunk?" he demanded. "Throw away your wine." "Oh no, sir," she replied. "I haven't been drinking wine or anything stronger. But I am very discouraged, and I was pouring my heart to the Lord. Don't think I am a wicked woman, for I have been praying out of great anguish and sorrow." Praise be the name of the Lord for the reading of His word. Amen. Again, our theme for today is the power of a mother's prayer. What makes a mother's prayer powerful? For you mothers in the house, do you make or do you want to make powerful prayers? Do you want to utter prayers that will move the heart of God and deliver great and awesome results? Well, we are going to take a look today at Hannah's particular prayer, and I hope that you will learn today how to deliver a powerful prayer to the Lord. If you want that, say amen. Amen. Now, just because it's Mother's Day, and just because the character of our story is a mother, that is the reason why I put the word mother on the theme. However, this message is not only applicable to mothers. This message is actually for all of us. Nataon lang na Mother's Day ngayon. So whether you are a male or a female, whether you are a boy or a girl, as long as you have a relationship with God, and as long as you are communicating to God with prayer, then this message is for you. You need to learn how to deliver powerful prayers to the Lord. And if you want that, I want to hear you say amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So what makes a prayer powerful? Paano ba nagiging makapangyarihan ang ating mga panalangin at hindi puro ngaw-ngaw lang? So, a prayer, a powerful prayer, is a prayer that is uttered in desperation. Everybody say desperation. So, the first thing that I would like to call your attention to is the pain that Hannah was experiencing in her life. Hannah was in extreme pain. But her pain was not an outward or physical pain. Instead, it was an inward or emotional pain. Siya ay nagdurusa, nagdurugo, pero hindi physical, kundi sa puso. In verse 10, it was described as a deep anguish, crying bitterly. Sa ibang translation, it is described as bitterness of the soul. Again, verse 10 says, Hannah was in deep anguish, crying bitterly as she prayed to the Lord. But again, going back to the story, why was Hannah in so much pain? Bakit nagdaramdam si Hannah? So first, the reason of her pain is because she desperately wanted to have a child. Hannah was barren. For many years, God has not opened her womb. You see, in the life of an adult married woman, pag ikaw adult na, may asawa ka na, there comes a time when you would long for a child. If you agree, fellow women, can I hear an amen? Darating yung panahon na gusto mo magkaanak. And that longing is not just a merely want, it becomes a desperate need. And then there is a sense of void or incompleteness for a woman for not having a child. But even more so, Hannah did not only want to have a child for herself, but Hannah desperately wanted to give her husband, whom he loved very much, a son. For some psychological reasons, you see, women achieve a sense of pride and accomplishment if they are able to bear a child for their husbands. Because a child would carry the genes and the name of their father. Lalo na sa ating mga Pilipino, for us Filipinos, our children carry the last name of our husbands. And for some psychological reasons, husbands become more endearing to their wives if they are given a child. Mga tatay, sino sa inyo yung mas minahal ang asawa noong binigyan kayo ng anak? Uy, umagree naman kayo para namang wala akong kausap. Huh? Husbands, did you love your wives more? Oh, when she was able to deliver children to you. Okay. Yan. Okay, this is our church. Please respond. Okay, hindi ako sanay sa tahimik na church. And so Hannah's barrenness is causing her so much pain. But aside from that fact, another pain that is causing Hannah is that she had an enemy that was tormenting her. Sino yung enemy niya? Penina. As if the pain of her barrenness was not enough, Penina did all she could to torment Hannah. Yung word na taunt, torment, make fun, ridicule. You see, Hannah and Penina, again, were both wives of Elkanah. So, ibig sabihin, magkaribal sila. O, sino dito sa inyo may mga karibal? Magkaribal sila. So, there was a constant competition between them. And so, I can imagine Penina, probably, okay, if I would reenact, Penina is there with her children around her. You see the picture? And then Elkanah would pass by. And then Penina would say, Elkanah, honey, isn't your son so guapo, so pogi? Aren't you glad that I was able to give you many, many children? And then Penina is there. I mean, Hannah is there. How would you feel if you were Hannah? So pinagdidikdikan ito ni Penina sa harap ni Hannah, pinamumukha niya na walang silbi si Hannah bilang asawa kay Elkanah. Ang sakit, hindi ba? Now you see, this is even more worse. Penina wasn't only Hannah's enemy. Hindi lang naman si Hana ang kalaban ni si Penina, nakakalitop tuloy. Hindi lang naman si Penina ang kalaban ni Hana dito. Because we can read from the Bible in Ephesians 6 verse 12, what does it say? For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but we wrestle with what? Against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. So it is very clear that behind the physical enemy is our spiritual enemy. Who is our spiritual enemy? None other than the devil, Satan himself. So no doubt, Satan was doing all he could to torment Hannah and make her life miserable. Now, practical application. How does this story apply to us? Hannah is not the only one who experiences pain in the soul. Many of us do. Pain in our soul occurs for many reasons. And the Bible teaches us that sometimes the Lord allows this pain in our soul. Sinasabi yun ng Bible, minsan pinapayagan ng Diyos na makaranas tayo ng mga sakit sa damdamin. But why? Why does God allow us to suffer painfully? Alam nyo kung bakit? This is what I believe. I believe that the Lord allows pain in order to bring us to a point of prayer. Amen? I repeat, I believe that the Lord allows pain in our lives in order to bring us to a point of prayer. Hinahayaan ng Diyos na tayo ay dumaan sa mga pagsubok, sa mga pasakit at bighati upang tayo ay madala sa kanyang trono, upang tayo ay lumuhod at manalangin. Do you realize that, church? You see, whether you are or not, aminin man ninyo o hindi, you are most willing to kneel down in prayer only in times of suffering or most of the time in suffering. Madalas, tsaka lang naman talaga tayo nananalangin ng taimtim at deboto kapag tayo desperado na. Pero hanggat hayahay pa ang buhay, baliwala ang oras ng panalangin. So, this is the reason why God sometimes allow pain to our souls in order to bring us to a point of prayer. If you understand that, say amen. And so, not only do we find Hannah's pain in the story, we can also see her prayer. Ano ba yung panalangin ni Hannah? In verse 9, it says, once after a sacrificial meal at Shiloh, Hannah got up and went to pray. And verse 10, Hannah was in deep anguish, crying bitterly as she prayed to the Lord. Please do not miss this, church. Hannah managed her pain and she managed her battle with Satan through prayer. Panalangin ang ginamit ni Hannah para i-manage niya yung kanyang pain and battle with her enemy. You see, it seems that the battle with her rival Penina went on for several years. Not just 1 year, not just 2 years, every year. And it got especially bad each year when they go to the temple to sacrifice, to offer sacrifices to God. So, let us note that every year, if they are there and Elkanah is giving the portions of meat, hayun naman, sinasamantala ni Penina na sirain at gawing miserable ang buhay ni Hannah. Penina would use this opportunity to rub Hannah's pain in her nose. So brethren, let us note that Satan has no mercy when he uses any of our situation to cause us fear and to fret. Ulitin ko. Remember that Satan will have no mercy na ipamukha sa'yo to show you that you are a loser. He would keep on whispering to you and telling to your face that you must fear, that you must worry, that you must be discouraged. Walang awa ang kaaway. Gagawin niya ang lahat para tayo manlupaypay at sumuko. And so, what did Hannah do to combat this? Anong ginawa ni Hannah para paglabanan itong nararamdaman niyang ito? Amen! Hannah had enough! And she was determined that she was going to the temple and she is going to pray until she got an answer from God. Dumating sa punto si Hannah at nabuo ang kanyang pasya na dumako sa templo upang manalangin hanggat sa makatanggap siya ng kasagutan sa Diyos. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, have you ever come to a point of pain where you are drawn desperately to the throne of God? Dumating ba kayo dun sa punto na desperadong-desperado na kayo? Na kinakailangan ninyong lumuhod sa trono ng Diyos? You see, for me, this happened many, many times. Because just like you, even if I am your senior pastor, I am also married. And naturally, marital issues normally arise, where me and my husband would also have major fights. There were times in my 15 years of marriage that I find myself desperately crying to God to save my marriage. Just like you, I also have a son. I also experienced times in his life growing up that he would have terrible sickness to the point of bringing him to Sick Kids Hospital. There were times when me and my husband would find ourselves desperately crying to God to heal our son. And for most of you, I'm sure that you have probably experienced, or maybe currently right now, you are experiencing various sorts of pain. And so in times of desperations, what are we to do? Give God a prayer of desperation, and you will see how powerful this prayer would be. Amen. Ang hinihintay ng Diyos ay ang paglapit natin sa Kanya na mga desperado. Because no one else can soothe your pain. You can not resolve your problem on your own. Only God can soothe that pain. God and God alone. Amen. So a powerful prayer is a prayer that is uttered in desperation. Amen. What else makes a powerful prayer? Point number two. A powerful prayer is a prayer that is full of dedication. A prayer with full dedication. Let us take a look at Hannah's prayer again. Tingnan natin yung panalangin ni Hannah. And she made this vow, O Lord of heaven's armies, if you look upon my sorrow and answer my prayer and give me a son, then I will give him back to you. He will be yours for his entire lifetime. And as a sign that he has been dedicated to the Lord, what was the vow? His hair will never be cut. As she was praying to the Lord, Eli watched her, and seeing her lips moving but hearing no sound, he thought she had been drinking. Lasing yata ito. Must you come here drunk? He demanded. Throw away your wine. Oh no, sir, I haven't been drinking wine or anything stronger, but I am very discouraged and I was pouring my heart to the Lord. Don't think that I am a wicked woman, for I have been praying out of great anguish and sorrow. A powerful prayer is not only a prayer of desperation, but it is also a prayer full of dedication. What does dedication mean? Dedication according to Cambridge English Dictionary, it is the willingness to give a lot of time and energy into something because it is important. So dedication, ibig sabihin, marami kang oras na ginugugol dito. Marami kang energy na ini-spend dito. Bakit? Kasi importante yun sa'yo. That's why you have a dedication to it. Now the question, church, how dedicated are we in our prayer time to the Lord? How dedicated are you in your prayer time to the Lord? Is it the same dedication that you spend 8 hours a day at work? Yung iba nga sa inyo, up to 12 hours, 16 hours pa kung makapagtrabaho. Ganong klase ba ng dedication meron tayo sa pananalangin? Is it the same dedication when you watch your Netflix and telenovelas every day? Na ayaw mong palampasin ang isang araw na hindi mo nasubaybayan ang isang episode? Are you as dedicated when you spend hours on the telephone or on messenger talking to your girlfriend or boyfriend? Wala naman kayong sinasabi, naka-on lang yung phone nyo. Or when you spend hours with your best friend talking about other people? How dedicated are we in our prayer time? Ano bang ibig sabihin ng dedication? Let's be more practical. Dedication means persistence. Everybody say persistence. Here we can see Hannah's persistent prayer. So verse 12, and it came to pass as she what? Continued praying before the Lord. Yung salitang continue, it means Hannah did not only pray once, she continued to pray. She took the time. Remember, I told you earlier, they went to Shiloh to offer sacrifices for many days, not just one day, not just 1 hour, not just 3 hours, many days. And Hannah, while she was there, continued to pray. She took the time. She lingered in the temple. She soaked in prayer. You see, during the time of Jesus, in his ministry on earth, this persistence in prayer has also been his topic. Tinuro ng Panginoong Jesus ang persistence in prayer. Jesus taught this not just once, not just twice. Marami siyang examples. He even said parables about this. Now, let's take a look at one instance in Matthew chapter 15. Matthew chapter 15 talks about an incident of a woman praying to Jesus persistently. Let's read the story. A Canaanite woman from that vicinity came to him. She came to Jesus. And she was crying out loud, "Lord, Son of David, have mercy on me. My daughter is demon-possessed and suffering terribly." Jesus did not answer a word. So his disciples came to him and urged him, "Jesus, send her away because she keeps crying out after us." Now Jesus answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of Israel." The woman came and knelt before him, "Lord, help me," she said. And he replied, "It is not right to take the children's bread and toss it to the dogs." "Yes, it is, Lord," she said. "But even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall on the master's table." Then Jesus said to her, "Woman, you have great faith. Your request is granted." And her daughter was healed at that moment. Do you see the persistence of this mother's prayer? Again, let's go back to the story, no? First, the woman came to Jesus, crying out with a loud voice. Ang ingay-ingay niya, nag-iiyak siya. "Lord, Son of David, have mercy on me. My daughter is demon-possessed, suffering terribly." But what was the reaction of Jesus? Are you following, church? What was the reaction of Jesus? Jesus did not answer a word. Hindi siya pinansin o inimik man lang ni Jesus. Kung kayo yung babae, how would you feel? And so, ito pa, Even the disciples, they came to Jesus. And what did the disciples suggest to Jesus? Jesus sent her away. She keeps crying out. Mga disipula niya nairita. Gusto siyang ipagtabuyan ni Jesus. Now, to add insult to the injury, ito pa. Jesus even gave her a very hurtful comment. Ang sakit ng comment ni Jesus sa babaeng ito. What did Jesus say? Jesus answered, I was only sent to the lost sheep of Israel. What does this mean? This is what it means. It means, woman, you are not an Israelite. You are not a beneficiary. I was only sent to the lost sheep of Israel. You are not a sheep of Israel. Ganun ang ibig sabihin nun. You do not belong to my people. But what did the woman do after hearing this comment? Anong sagot ng babae? The woman came. Asan na ako? And knelt before the Lord. And she said, Lord, help me. Anong sagot ni Jesus? Mas masakit na response na naman. An even hurtful response. Jesus said, you know what? It's not right to take the children's bread and toss it to the dogs. What was Jesus trying to say here? Jesus was saying that the bread is only intended for the children. This woman is not one of the children, but she is likened to a dog. Yung tinapay na dala ko para lang sa mga anak ko, ikaw aso ka. Hindi para sa'yo ang tinapay na ito. But what was the response of the woman? Yes, it is, Lord. I am a dog. But isn't it that even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table? Nakipagsagutan! Nakipagkatwiran ang babaeng ito kay Jesus. The woman argued and insisted with Jesus that even if she is compared to a dog, isn't it that even the dogs benefit from the mumu, the crumbs that fall from their master's table? Wow. And so because of her persistence, what was the response of Jesus?
Asan na yon? Wala na ako.
The response of Jesus, woman, you have great faith. Your request is granted. And at that moment, her daughter was healed. Amen. Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon. Hallelujah! What a powerful, persistent prayer. The woman did not give up. She gave all her energy. She gave her full dedication despite the implied denial and rejection of Christ. And because of her persistence in prayer, the Lord granted her request. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, question, church, how is your persistence in prayer? Nasubukan nyo na bang kulitin ang Diyos? At ipagpumilit ang inyong mga iyak sa Diyos, mga kapatid? Maybe others are saying, oh my, ganun pala, pwede pala yun? This is an example, isn't it? Have you just prayed once? Or maybe twice? And then afterward, you did not follow up anymore? Have you prayed maybe 3 times and then eventually you gave up when you have not heard an answer? What can we learn from here, church? Gusto pala ng Diyos na tayo ay maging masugid sa ating mga panalangin. God, we can learn here that God wants us to be persistent, to be insistent in our prayers. It is not because God wants to torture us or to humiliate us or to punish us. No, that's not the reason. But it is because God wants us to develop our faith. God wants us to keep on pushing And by pushing, it means pray until something happens. Yun ang ibig sabihin ng P-U-S-H, pray until something happens. God does not want us to give up. God wants us to keep coming to Him, to keep crying out to Him, to present our petitions with a fervent belief and faith that He will not turn His ears away from us. Now again, Jesus taught the importance of persistence. Merong tinatawag na the parable of the persistent widow. Diba? I'm teaching to you about the parables. Now I'm not going to read the story anymore. Read it in your own time in Luke chapter 18. But in that parable, in verse 1, it says there, then Jesus told His disciples a parable to show them what? That they should always pray and not give up. Napakagandang basahin nung kwento. Basahin nyo pag-uwi nyo, Luke chapter 18, the parable of the persistent widow. Now, madalas kasi sinasabi natin, oh, may problema ka, pinag-pray mo na ba? Oo, pinag-pray ko na te. But after one and two prayers, did you pray again and again? Mga kapatid, si Jesus na mismo ang nagsasabi sa atin. Huwag na kayong magduda. Si Jesus mismo ang nagsasabi sa atin. Jesus Himself is telling us, we should always pray and we must not give up. Amen? Push. What does push mean? Pray. Say it to the person beside you. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Push. Push pa more. You see, when the Israelites were about to conquer the city of Jericho, they did not only march around the city once, but how many times did we march around the city? 7 times. When Isaiah was praying God for rain, he did not only pray once, he did not only pray twice, he prayed 3 times the same prayer. When God told Naaman to dip himself in the Jordan River, maligo ka doon sa Jordan River, hindi lang minsan, 2, 3, 4, 5 beses. But why many times? Bakit kaya ganun ng Diyos? Bakit kailangan pa ulit-ulit? Why is it not enough to just call on the Lord once? Lord, di ba sabi mo, one word is enough for the wise? Bakit sa'yo kailangan pa ulit-ulit? The lesson for today, guys, it is because God is testing our faith. And He wants us to keep coming back to Him with persistence. God is teaching us not to easily give up. God is teaching us that if we keep pushing, if we keep on persisting, if we keep on exercising at faith, yun ang nagme-melt. That is what melts the heart of God. Amen? Naantig ang puso ng Diyos kapag tayo ay masugid, nagpupumilit, nagmamakaawa, hindi nagsasawang umabot sa kanyang puso, umabot sa kanyang awa at biyaya. So a prayer that is full of dedication is a persistent prayer. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, dedication does not only mean persistence, but dedication also means passion. Everybody say passion. Let's take a look at Hannah's passionate prayer. As she was praying to the Lord, Eli was watching her. Eli is the high priest, right? And seeing her lips moving, but hearing no sound. Nakakita na ba kayo ng ganyan? Gumagalaw yung bibig, pero wala namang sound. He thought she had been drinking. Kailangan bang pumunta ka dito ng lasing? Tapon mo yung alak mo. Throw away your wine. Okay, now you know already the dialogue. I don't have to keep on reenacting. Eli did not hear a word from her mouth. Yet, there was so much passion in her prayer that he thought she was drunk. Matanong ko sa inyong mga umiinom, ano bang itsura ng lasing? What does a drunk person look like anyway? Okay, maraming itsura ng iba't ibang mga klase ng lasing. Pero this is what I notice, ano? When you are drunk, lasing ka, you don't care about your composure, right? You don't care about how you look like anymore. A drunk person could not stand up or sit up straight anymore. A drunk person looks miserable. Pakitignan niya yung katabi kung mukhang lasing. Okay, listen guys. Okay, quiet na. Marami kayong side comments dyan. I know when you get excited, you can't help but talk to your neighbors. But let's listen. So why is a passionate prayer compared to what a drunk person looks like? Ganito kasi yan. Are you listening, guys? When you are passionately praying, you are not conscious anymore whether your eyeliner, mascara, and lipstick are all smudged up together in your face. Naghahalo na yung luha, sipon, laway. Wala ka nang pakialam. When you are passionately praying, you just want to get down on your knees. You just want to fall on the ground, praying out of great anguish and sorrow. Now, brothers and sisters, have you ever experienced praying like that? Many times. Now, the question, when was the last time? Now, of course, ito makinig kayo. Please don't get me wrong. Because there is a proper time for everything. You don't want to be looking extreme just like this when you are just praying for the food or praying for the offering. Tama? An appropriate time to pray like this is when you are locked up in your room praying alone. Or it is also appropriate to pray like this during the night of fire, when we allow the free manifestation of the Holy Spirit in our prayers. Or it is also appropriate to pray like this in your small groups, when you are praying for one another, especially when you are in a prayer warfare. These are the times that it is appropriate to offer this kind of passionate and dedicated prayers to the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, dedication does not only mean persistence and passion, but here we can also see Hannah's prayer of presentation. Looking again in verse 11, ito na yung vow. This is the promise of Hannah. He presented an offer to the Lord. Sabi ni Hannah, Jesus, I want to present to you my offer. Ba? Nakipag-bargain si Hannah sa Diyos. What was that? O Lord of hosts, if you will indeed look at the affliction of your maidservant, if you will remember me, if you will not forget me, I will give your maidservant a male child. But if you will give your maidservant a male child, then what? Then I will give him to the Lord all the days of his life, and no razor shall come upon his head. Okay, this is a different doctrine. Bakit hindi pwedeng gupitan ang buhok? Okay, there is what you call the Nazirite. Being a Nazirite, being set apart, there is a vow. There are three vows. Their hair will never be cut or shaved. Second, they will never touch grapes. And third, they will never touch a dead body. That is a Nazirite vow, which was applicable then during that time. But this is what I want to be painted in your mind. Hindi yung hindi pagpapagupit. Ang gusto kong maitatak sa utak ninyo is that she promised that she will dedicate, give her son to the Lord all the days of his life. Church, a prayer that is full of dedication is a prayer of presentation. A practical application to this. It has been a practice in our church. And it is encouraged that every parent must present their child to God. And we do this in a form of child dedication. Can I hear an amen? Yung iba naaantala lang, na ipagpapaliban lang yung child dedication kasi ang nagiging focus yung gagastusin sa party. Which is not supposed to be the motive. Hindi porket walang panglitson, hindi matutuloy. No! Kung gusto nyo, ngayon na, i-dedicate natin ang anak nyo sa Panginoon. Ang gandang pagkakataon, Mother's Day. May party man o wala, what is important is that when God has given you the fruit of your womb, you have made a commitment to God that you will dedicate and offer your child back to Him. Now, aside from child dedication, I don't know if you have noticed, but whenever I officiate, I do not only dedicate the child, I also dedicate the parents. Kayong mga magulang, kailangan nyong i-dedicate at i-present ang mga sarili ninyo sa Panginoon. Why? Because you will need all the help and guidance from God in order to accomplish your purpose as guardians to your children. If you do not dedicate yourselves to the Lord, mawawala kayo. You will be chaotic in bringing up your children to God. But if you allow God to guide you in rearing your children, your child will grow up in the way that he should be. Amen? Now, generally speaking, we are not only talking here about child and parent dedication programs. It's not just about the program. But even more important and all the more, if you want your prayers to be powerful, you need to present what? You need to present your lives to God. Wala naman tayong ibang iaalay sa Kanya eh. Hindi yung love gift natin o offering natin o tithes natin, yung sarili mo. What matters most is that you present your bodies to Christ. Amen? Holy and acceptable to Him. The kind of prayer that God is waiting is not when you ask the Lord this or that. Hindi yun ang hinihintay ng Panginoon na panalangin. Kasi madalas, saka lang tayo nananalangin pag sabi natin, Lord, bilmo ko nyan. Gusto ko yon, gusto ko yan. That is when we usually pray. But God is waiting for a kind of prayer wherein you dedicate and you present yourself to Him. Ang pinakamakapangyarihang panalangin, the most powerful prayer to God is when you said to Him, Lord, I present myself to you. Lord, I surrender my all to you. Lord, I am yours. My life is in your hands. I belong to you. Therefore, use me for your glory. Lord, I surrender my family to you. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Amen. Yan ang pinakamakapangyarihang panalangin na aantig sa Panginoon. Why? Because if you are serving Him, He is your Father, He is your Shepherd, if you are following His footsteps, you will never go wrong. Hindi ka mapapariwara. Hindi ka mapapabayaan. Bakit? Nakasunod ka sa yapak niya. At yan ang pinakamakapangyarihan sa lahat. Can I hear an amen? Amen. Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon. Praise the Lord! So once again, a powerful prayer is a prayer uttered in desperation. A prayer that is full of dedication, third and the last. A powerful prayer is a prayer offered in celebration. Amen. Hallelujah. Merong celebratory prayer. Kayo ba nananalangin kayo ng may kagalakan, may celebration? This is also known as a thanksgiving prayer. Panalangin ng pasasalamat, panalangin ng rejoicing, panalangin ng celebration. So Hannah and Elkanah celebrated when God gave them a son. God honored Hannah's desperate prayer. God gave him a very special son. You see, Samuel, kilala niyo ba si Samuel sa Bible? He is perhaps one of the greatest men in the Old Testament. And no doubt about it that Elkanah and Hannah celebrated when they discovered that she was pregnant. And then at Samuel's birth, Hannah and Elkanah named their son Samuel. What is the meaning of Samuel? Heard from God. Dininig ng Panginoon. Dininig ng Diyos. Wow! Sino bang may pangalan na Samuel dito? Ang ganda! So every time she calls his name, Samuel, she was reminded to celebrate the Lord's goodness. Wow! Kayo, ano bang mga pinangalan ninyo sa mga anak ninyo? XYZ? Do the names of your children have meanings? You see, there are power in words. So, pangalanan nyo yung mga anak ninyo ng may declaration. I name my son Axel Rain. Axel means father of peace. And rain, ulan, means blessing. It was raining hard when I gave birth to him. And tomorrow, my son is turning 15. I am blessed to be a mother. Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Glory to God! I celebrate the goodness of God in my life. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Mamaya, may kapagkain tayo dito. Praise the Lord! Nagdala ang lahat. Amen! So, second celebration, Hannah celebrated when she gave her son back to God. Chapter 1 pa rin, verse 24. When the child was weaned, ano yung weaned? Napusot. Ano sa Tagalog yun? Yung hindi na dumidede. Yung naihiwalay na sa dede ng nanay. Ha? Gusto kong malaman yung Tagalog version. Inawat. Mawalay. O kung ano man yun. Okay, weaned. When the child was weaned, Hannah took him to the tabernacle in Shiloh. They brought along a 3-year-old bull for the sacrifice and a basket of flour and some wine. After sacrificing the bull, they brought the boy to Eli. Shh, makinig na sa kwento. Sir, do you remember me? Hannah asked. I am the very woman who stood here several years ago praying to the Lord. I asked the Lord to give me this boy, and he has granted my request. Now, I am giving him to the Lord, and he will belong to the Lord his whole life. And they worship the Lord there. Do you know how old the baby boy Samuel was at this time? You know how old he was when he was brought to the temple to live there and to serve there? According to some Bible scholars, katatapos lang maihiwalay sa dede ng nanay. So, he was just old enough not to breastfeed from his mom anymore. So, it is believed that at that time, he is not more than 4 or 5. Most likely less than 4. Hannah did not forget her promise to God. Kung ikaw yung nanay, ayaw mong mawala yung anak mo sa'yo, pinagkahintay-hintay mo, tapos mahihiwalay. As much as any mother would want to, Hannah did not keep her son to herself. She kept her promise. And she did not wait any longer anymore. She dedicated her son to live and serve in the temple even at very young age. Now take a look at this. Chapter 2 na. Jumping now to the next chapter. Verse 18. But Samuel, though he was only a boy, he served the Lord. Wow, cute. Parang 4 years old. Sino bang 4 years old dito? Serving the Lord. Baby boy Samuel was wearing a linen garment just like a priest. Uy, may maliit na pari. Palakad-lakad sa temple. And each year, his mother made a small coat for him and brought it to him when she came with her husband for the sacrifice. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, before they return home, Eli would bless Elkanah and his wife, and he would say, "May the Lord give you other children to take the place of the one she gave to the Lord." I just can imagine Hannah beaming with pride whenever she sees her little boy walking around in the temple looking like a small priest. His son being used for God's glory. Mothers, aren't you happy when you see your children dancing here for the Lord? Kahit magbayad pa ako ng Uber every Sunday, hindi mababayaran yung tuwa na nakikita mo yung anak mong nagpupuri sa Panginoon. That's a celebratory prayer to the Lord. You don't need to utter words to Him anymore. The fact that you come here, bringing your children, giving thanks to Him, proudly videoing your son and your daughter, and posting online that she is worshiping the Lord. What a celebration. Natutuwa ang Panginoon. Now, there is actually more to Hannah's celebration. And this is the highlight of them all. Hannah celebrated when God gave her more sons and daughters. Wow. And the Lord blessed Hannah, and she conceived and gave birth to 3 more sons and 2 more daughters. Praise be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. At the beginning of the story, all Hannah ever wanted was to have one son. But God gave her above and beyond her heart's desire. The Lord granted her fervent request, but even exceeded her expectation. Humingi lang si Hannah ng isa, pero binayayaan siya ng 5 pa. Amen. Oh, how gracious and abundant is the love and generosity of God. Ito, mga kapatid, this is the meaning of our year 5 church anniversary theme. Our theme was above and beyond. And I want to remind you, Ephesians 3:20, now unto Him who is able to do above and beyond all that we ask or think, according to the power that works in us, to Him be the glory in the church and in Christ Jesus to all generations forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Church, if we are only able to learn how to pray powerfully, surely God will hear the deep cries of our hearts. I am now ending the message here. But right now, mga kapatid, God wants us to apply what we have learned. The Lord has been waiting for your fervent prayers. And God has already taught us. He has already spoken to us what touches His heart. Ano bang klase ng panalangin ang aabot sa puso ng Diyos? God is waiting for us to cry to Him in deep desperation. Give them all to Jesus. Give Him your pain. Give Him your shame. Give Him your doubts, your fears, your troubles, your anxieties. Give Him all your sorrows. Cast all your cares upon Him. There is nowhere else to go but to God alone. Cry out to Him. Say, "God, I'm desperate for You. I am lost without You. I need Thee. Oh, I need Thee. Every hour, I need Thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. I come to Thee."